Hi, this is Kelly. You're chatting with Kelly Z. We're at NAMM 2013 at the Dean Markley booth with Lita Ford.
We're at the...
Tell me your relationship with Dean Markley.
Oh, I've been using Dean Markley for quite a while now. They have pretty much redone the company. They've taken over, a new gentleman has taken over the company, and he's really, really made the strings awesome. I have stacks all over my house of Dean Markley strings. They kick ass, absolutely kick ass. So I love Dean Markley.
I know you have a new album. Tell me a little bit about that.
It's called Living Like a Runaway. It was pretty much written after I filed for divorce. And it's a bit of an empowering album for people that want to just say, screw you to the world, you know? It's like, I'm going to get through this, and this is how I'm going to get through it, you know? And a lot of people turn to music. A lot of people turn to music for if they're sick, or if they're happy, they're getting married, they're having a wedding, they put on their favorite song. Definitely. I mean, music makes the world go round, you know.
It's kind of therapy.
Really is. Yeah.
So what's your songwriting process? Do you have a set one, or does it change?
I like to say in rock and roll, there really isn't any rules.
Yeah.
So whatever your process is of songwriting, it doesn't matter. You know, so long as in the end you get a song out of it. Sometimes I'll come up with a title and I'll write a chorus around that title. Or sometimes I just hear something in my head and I figure it out on guitar. Or sometimes something will happen and I'll think, oh my God, that's a song. I got to write a song about that. You know, there's all kinds of different ways of writing. There are no rules.
So
no rules in rock and roll.
I love it. So what guitar do you play?
BC Rich.
Awesome. I know you're going over there soon to do some signings over there. What do you like about that guitar?
Well, I've been playing them for a long time, first of all. When I was in the Runaways, I started with Hamers, and I had a Gibson SG. And then, I used Marshalls and Orange amps, and I never used effects. I always just plugged straight into the amp, and I used to cross my channels on the old Marshalls, so it would give it a natural distortion, because I never used any distortion pedals, and it just kind of went wham, and it had this real nasty growl to it, which you couldn't get unless you used some sort of pedal or something. And then when they started making BC Riches, they started putting in these little power amp switches, and I fell in love with them. I would hit this little switch on my BC Rich, and it sounded like death. It just sounded like death. I didn't have to use any delays, or I didn't have to use any power amps or anything. I had it built right into my guitar, and it made my life so much easier. I didn't have to have pedal boards and all that stuff that I think personally is unnecessary. So, I don't know. The guitar sounded dirty, grungy. For me, it sounded the way I wanted a guitar to sound.
Well, you sound like you have a lot of passion for it, and that's the way it should be. So thank you so much for talking to me. Lita Ford with Chat with Kelly Z. We're at NAMM 2013.
Woohoo!